An asynchronous method is a method that can return before it has finished executing. Any method that performs a potentially long-running task, such as accessing a web resource or reading a file, can be made asynchronous to improve the responsiveness of the program. This is especially important in graphical applications, because any method that takes a long time to execute on the user interface thread will cause the program to be unresponsive while waiting for that method to complete. C# 5.0 introduced two new keywords to simplify the way to write asynchronous methods. To use these keywords, Visual Studio 2012 or later needs to be used. The target framework, found under Project Properties, also needs to be set to at least version 4.5. The async and await keywords can then be used. They allow asynchronous methods to be written with a simple structure similar to synchronous, regular methods. The async modifier specifies that the method is asynchronous, and that it can therefore contain one or more await expressions. An await expression consists of the await keyword, followed by an awaitable method call. To illustrate how this asynchronous method is executed, two output statements are added. The method will run synchronously until the await expression is reached, at which point the method is suspended, and execution returns to the caller. The awaited task is scheduled to run in the background on the same thread. In this case, the task is a time delay that will complete after 2000 milliseconds. Once the task is complete, the remainder of the async method will execute. Calling my async from the main method here will output AB, followed by C after the delay. Note the use of the readKey method here to prevent the console program from exiting before the async method has finished. An async method can have one of three built-in return types: void, task, and generic task. Specifying task or void denotes that the method does not return a value, whereas a generic task means it will return a value of the specified type. In contrast to void, the task and generic task types are awaitable, so a caller can use the await keyword to suspend itself until after the task has finished. The void type is mainly used to define async event handlers, as event handlers require a void return type. In order to call a method asynchronously, it has to be wrapped in another method that returns a started task. To illustrate, the following method defines starts and returns a task which takes 2000 milliseconds to execute before it returns the letter Y. The task is here defined through the use of a lambda expression for conciseness. This task method can be called asynchronously from an async method. The naming convention for these methods is to append async to the method name. The asynchronous method in this example awaits the result of the task and then prints it. The async method is called in the same way as a regular method, as shown before, and the output of this program is X followed by Y.